For years, Musk has been talking about the desire to colonize Mars and slowly but surely move people from Earth to our neighboring red planet. In 2001, before SpaceX and Tesla were formally founded, Musk threw around his idea that was later nicknamed Mars Oasis. Part concept, part plan of action. Musk detailed his vision for putting a greenhouse on Mars and attempting to grow food through the use of hydroponics and other agricultural advancements. Video footage of this would then be broadcast back to Earth, and voila! People would be interested in science again, and would eventually find themselves warming to the idea that civilization can exist on the red planet. Mars Oasis gained some traction, but eventually, it was put aside in the interest of pursuing much larger goals, such as the reusable rockets that SpaceX is now utilizing. Musk also realized what a financial and logistical headache the process could be, and understood then that he would need more time and more resources to get this plan off the ground. Fast forward to 2014, when Elon Musk sat down for an interview with the digital magazine Aeon. In speaking with Ross Anderson, the former deputy editor of the magazine, Musk described much of his reasoning for wanting to explore space and colonize Mars, as opposed to finding solutions to some of the greatest problems that are plaguing Earth, such as poverty, disease, and climate change. He said, "I think there is a strong humanitarian argument for making life multiplanetary in order to safeguard the existence of humanity in the event that something catastrophic were to happen." Musk added that, "Though these are important issues, we are virtually racing against time, and therefore need to prioritize where we're dedicating our attention. Those problems would be rendered irrelevant because, according to him, humanity would be extinct by the time a viable solution could be proposed." Enter Mars, the planet Musk thinks will be the savior of all humanity, or at least a current solution to the theory that civilization is on borrowed time. Incredibly, Musk thinks that the sustainable colonization of Mars could happen within a century. His plan is to, over time, send up at least 1 million people to Mars so that true diversification could take place. These million people would, he said, have to understand that their lives will be completely different on Mars, as they would be reliant upon cargo shipments and waiting on reinforcements to arrive on their planet. It wouldn't be the instantaneous consumer-driven system we have on Earth. Musk is, however, hopeful. In 2017, Musk began to speak about another phenomenon in conjunction with his multiplanetary goals, the idea of demographic implosion, also known as population implosion. Simply put, the implosion happens when, in any particular country, the amount of elderly individuals grossly outweighs the amount of younger individuals. Musk believes that due to the declining birth rates around the world, this is not going to happen in just a few countries. Population implosion is going to be a global occurrence. In an interview with CNN, Musk explained that humanity originally evolved to procreate, and that it was common practice centuries ago for families to have a lot of children in the hopes that some, if not all, would survive. Now, in the advent of technology and, as Musk pointed out, birth control, rates of birth are controlled and thus declining. Citing research that came out in 2013, Musk explained, "You've got cases like Japan where adult diapers outsell baby diapers." Besides a bad diaper joke, what is concerning about an elderly population outgrowing everyone else? Musk answered this from an economic standpoint. The ratio of retired individuals, the individuals who are no longer working and producing, to younger, working individuals will be staggeringly high, meaning that the smaller group of working, producing individuals will have a difficult time sustaining and providing for their elderly counterparts. The healthcare industry will feel these effects in addition to the global workforce, hence the implosion. To highlight the decline, in 1990, the total global fertility rate, which refers to the amount of babies one woman will have in her lifetime, was 3.2. In 2021, the global fertility rate dropped to 2.3. Of course, many speculate that the COVID-19 pandemic had something to do with this lower number. Yet the decline was in place far before the onset of the pandemic. From 2000 to 2005, for instance, the average rate was 2.65. As he spoke more and more about population implosion that year, taking much of his opinions to his favorite social media platform, Twitter, he was met with mixed reactions. After retweeting the article from New Scientist about an impending population bomb, Musk wrote, "The world's population is accelerating towards collapse, but few seem to notice or care." This was a month before his appearance on CNN Money. Some people responded favorably, while others responded by doing some math to show that his calculations were off. One writer, Grisanik, posted on his blog that each year 135 million people are added to the growing global population, which at the time of his blog post in 2017 was 7.5 billion. He went on to say that since 57 million are subtracted, the total population increases by 78 million people. Even if all reproduction paused for 10 years, he theorized, the global population would return to 6.8 billion people, which was the approximate number of inhabitants on Earth back in 2009. Anik ended his post by stating that global warming and human-made damage to the Earth is one of the strongest reasons for curbing population increases, and that Musk should not be encouraging a higher global birth rate. If we don't address these man-made issues, he said, it could be a fatal mistake. Other critics of Musk's theories have said similar things, admitting that, though he is correct that we are in a fertility rate decline, his motives for wanting to colonize Mars because of that are misguided. In September of 2019, environmental scientist Leon Kalinowicz stated that though Musk might be right about global population collapse, he's focusing on the wrong things. He then cited Musk's comments at the 2019 World Artificial Intelligence Conference, in which the Tesla founder held a debate with Jack Ma. During the discussion, Musk called the view that there are too many people on the planet outdated and reiterated his collapse theory. The Earth, said Kalinowicz, is already struggling to provide for the roughly 220,000 humans that are born each day, as we face dwindling resources and what he called a beleaguered climate. Therefore, if a population collapse were to occur, it would not be because people aren't having babies. It would be because the Earth's resources simply could not take the strain we are putting upon them. Since his 2019 debate with Jack Ma, Musk has only doubled down on his claims, adding that because the population of Mars is currently zero, it's the perfect planet to explore and help continue civilization, which is headed towards an obvious demise on Earth. If no one was listening to him back then, the COVID-19 pandemic made people pay attention. On July 26, 2021, Musk retweeted an article from the Wall Street Journal entitled, U.S. Population Growth, an Economic Driver, Grinds to a Halt. The article mentioned that across the United States, more people had died than were born in 2020. And in looking at the year ending on July 1, 2020, the U.S. population had only grown 0.35%, the lowest percentage of growth ever recorded. This is, of course, concerning, and Musk captioned his retweet with a refrain he's been using for years. Population collapse is potentially the greatest risk to the future of civilization. Earlier that month, in a more lighthearted show of his support for population growth, Musk tweeted a photo of him and his son writing, I'm trying to set a good example. He went on to say in the same post, humans are the custodians of other life on Earth. Let us bring life to Mars. In a win for SpaceX, flight tests for their Starship, a combination of Starship spacecraft and Super Heavy rocket, have proven to be successful multiple times over, giving more hope toward an upcoming date to launch civilians on a journey toward Mars. According to their website, Starship is a fully reusable transportation system that is capable of carrying crew and cargo to Earth orbit, the Moon, Mars, and beyond. This is the vessel that Musk plans to use when he sends the first 100 civilians to the Red Planet. Will he succeed? Well, let's wait and see. And finally, if you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. It's easy, it's free, and it will be great support for us. Of course, if you won't like it, you can always unsubscribe.